Hey guys, Justin here. I'm in Fremantle right now and back to another day of train filming. So we'll start from Fremantle and end at Mandurah. That's today's request vlog. But this request vlog is kind of lame. Not really lame because the systems here is just basically every single time when I need to change trains, I need to go to Perth to change trains. So basically every single time we will be actually touching Perth. So basically every single time it will be just like two full journeys or basically the stuff that we need to use in Perth. But hopefully we can do some different lines. We're just using the Fremantle line today, and the fortunate is that I actually got a lot of requests using the Armadale and the Mandurah line. Not too much on the Joondalup line and the Midland line. So that's why hopefully you guys can actually go ahead and manage and request. If you guys want to request, if you want to request things, please like try to make things interesting instead of just commenting the same old lines all over the place. Thank you so much, Carl Galway, for this request here. Thank you. And we'll start basically just two full journeys. This vlog is going to be, you can expect 1 hour and 30 minutes. Okay, so it's going to be, again, one A train and one B train for this one. So because basically it's two full journeys. The Fremantle line full journey, it is 30 minutes. And then the Mandurah line full journey is around 50 to 55 minutes. Plus the waiting time in Perth, which is still unknown to me. What is the waiting time? But hopefully I don't need to wait that long. Last time I need to wait for 10 minutes for that last vlog, so. Next station, North Fremantle. Another train crossing the bridge over there, I saw it. Which is the very awesome looking bridge with no railings. North Fremantle. Apparently North Fremantle is on the right. I thought it was actually on the left, but I guess not. Also, today, when you're watching this premiere, all MRRs have been, I mean, I'm talking in Hong Kong, all the East Rail Line MRRs, they have retired. Today is the last day. Now I'm filming, this one's actually at 11:30, so the last MRR service will be at 1 o'clock. Would have actually was at 1 o'clock today. And yeah, there they all go. I think the last train that they retire will be the 1114 train. So E114 is the last train to be demolished. So today is the last day for MRR service. That's really unfortunate. I can never take MRRs again, but looking forward to the East Rail Line Harbour extension. And when I return to Hong Kong, I will rush to film that as soon as I arrive in Hong Kong. Next station, Victoria Street. Now, I'm not familiar with the Fremantle line, I've only taken it once. Today is the second time I take this one. Actually, I've taken it definitely not two times, but from Fremantle all the way through, it's just the second time. Because I've taken one time to film a bus journey. Victoria Street, doors open on the left. What's the next station? I forgot already. What's the next station? What park? Moorsman Park, I think. Is it? I don't remember. Yeah, Moorsman Park. I think also on the left. Next station, Cotswold. There's actually a Cotswold Beach close by here, which is actually an attraction. But the thing is, I hate bitches. Don't pronounce the word wrong. I hate beaches, so that's why. Be careful, it's a long word instead of a short one. It's a long syllable instead of a short syllable. Cotslow. I don't know why there's some extra platforms over that way. There's one extra platform over there, but it's just a random dumb platform. Oh my gosh, you gotta be kidding me. B-Train. B-Train is in today, 84. Apparently the 54 one is on the yellow line, Armadale, Forney, but this one is here on the Fremantle. Fremantle / Midland line services. Yeah, there they are. B-Train. Next station, Grant Street. The woman announcer is kind of not there for the Fremantle line. I'd rather have the male announcer. Next station, Swanbourne. And after Swanbourne is Clement, which is actually, I thought it was Claremont before, but apparently there's no U in that word, so that's why it's just Clement. Now also, there will be very soon some, I think, Fremantle line night closure. So they'll have the route, I think 90, I don't remember the route, 905, 906, I don't remember. Swanbourne. Next station, Claremont. Yeah, Claremont's just around the corner. the intervals of stations for this line is actually very close to each other, so that's why the time is not really that long for the whole route. For the whole line, it won't take too long. Here's the bus station last time when I took the buses. This is Claremont. Done. What's the next one? I forgot. Next station, Lodge Street. Do we actually have to pass through Showgrounds first? I think we do. Yeah, here's Showgrounds Station. Not in use today. I don't think it will actually rarely be in use, because I don't think any events will happen in Showgrounds. Showgrounds is the, I think, for horse racing. It's just like race course in Hong Kong. Turf Stadium is kind of something else. More trains. Next station, Karakata. Now, Karakata and Lost Street is basically just a one straight line, probably just walk for 5 minutes. We can actually be done with this little section. This is Karakata. Anyone getting on? Nope. If not, then we're not gonna turn. Apparently none of the doors are actually open for the whole train, so that's why the train just leaves without doing anything. I think next station is Subiaco, I think. Oh, Shenton Park first, not Subiaco. Yep, next station, Shenton Park. Now I'm actually considering to travel interstate during my semester break, which will be happening in mid-June to mid-July. and I planned to go to Adelaide for my, if I want to go travel interstate, I will travel to Adelaide for around a few days because I have my cousin living there, so I can visit him. So I might film the stuff over there. But for the trains, it's even worse design than Perth, because at least here you can actually change at Claysbrook for some of the lines. Claysbrook or McIver, you can change it that way. But for Adelaide, every single train just starts service at Adelaide and then goes to different directions. So Adelaide is the terminus for every single line. I believe. I've been to Adelaide before, and I've taken the trains one time, and it's like that, I think. I take them one of the lines. And also there are trams there, which is just like the light rail in Hong Kong, so I will also try to film those as well if I can. If I go over there, I'm still thinking about it. And the buses, I will try my best, but I won't be filming full journeys when I'm actually staying in Adelaide, because I don't know the apps. I don't have the apps for that one. So probably we're just going to film random traveling journeys for buses instead of filming the full journeys, because I'm not staying long. If I'm staying long, like here, then I'll film the full journeys. But if I'm not staying long, I'm not going to be filming the full journeys. Next station, Daglish. After Daglish is Subiaco. Oh, I can see the city already. It's somewhere over that side. I saw some buildings. Basically, in Australia, every single time you see high-rise buildings, that's in the city. Arrived at Daglish. On the right? Yes. Next station, Subiaco. One of my favorite station on the Fremantle line. Because it's just cool. Because we actually enters underground, and it actually stops underground. It's one of the few stations in Perth, in WA, that actually stops underground. If you accept Perth Underground and Elizabeth Quay, some random stations outside the city actually stops underground. Subiaco. This is one of the biggest stations, so a lot of people getting on right now.
Yeah. Doors closes.
Next station, West Leederville. Almost in the city. Rush over the Perth Underground afterwards. Hopefully I don't need to wait for 10 minutes again like last time. West Leederville. Next station, City West. Not, it's the accent is not west, it's west. West, not west, it's west. Next station, City West. After I came to Australia, my accent's already changed to Australian accent. Usually I'm actually a pure American accent boy. But yeah, after I arrived, just changed to Australian accents already. Can't help it. Every single time when I listen to other people talking, it's just speaking Australian accents, so I just learn from them. It's still not the perfect Australian accent. I'm still getting it there. But yeah. City West. Basically in the city already, it's just the west side. We get off at the next station, Perth. Okay, but today, long time not been to Mandurah, so I guess I can go to Mandurah. The thing is, I'm just gonna go to Mandurah and then get back out because there's nothing I can do in Mandurah. Station, Perth. It won't say it in here, but this train runs from Perth to Midland, stopping at all stations.
Thank you.
Arrived at Perth. Doors open on the left. Unfortunately, the worst spot for changing trains. We're at the front of the train. The exit, the only exit is at the back of the train. That's stupid. Alright, arrived at Perth. Now we head down to the Mandurah Line platform.
Down south.
This is still quite a walk, but let's just get over there. It's at the front of the platform.
Yeah, we're escalated there.
You can connect to Perth Busport from here, but just get out the gates and then walk on the road. Looks like they will shut down the Midland Line later on at the by the end of the year, around September, to actually get the Bayswater station built. Yeah. Basically, the Bayswater station, they're building a new Bayswater station to replace the old one right now. How many minutes? You gotta be kidding me. Even worse than last time. Damn it! 12 minutes. You gotta be fucking kidding me. Every single time. Just cannot get the perfect timing. Yeah, I don't even need to run this one because it's so long. Still need to take, so. So last time, when I actually do some filmings, there are a train disruption at night between Perth Underground and Auburn Grove on the Mandurah Line. So that's my Mandurah Line service from Auburn Grove over to Mandurah, this section only. And for Joondalup Line, usually connects with Perth Underground and over the Mandurah Line, but on that day it stops at Perth Station, not Underground, Perth Platform 6, that's the... That's the platform they not in use, and they just use that for like the Optus Stadium special trains and the some of the special services. I'm not going to be doing the lift series here in Perth because it's kind of pointless. Every single lift that are the same, so. But we can do a little bit here. Nine more minutes again. Even worse than last time. Last time when I come down, it's 8 minutes. This time it's 9. Crappy crap. then you guys need to expect. Yeah, then you guys need to expect 1 hour and 30 minutes for this video. Yeah, I'm heading to the front of the train again because I actually do like it at the front over here. Alright, so just wait for trains. While we wait for trains, we just want to talk a little bit. I have no idea when the airport line is going to come out for the extension of the Midland Line section. It's not extension, another branch section of the Midland Line going over to the airport. But a new thing is actually this year, but I don't know whether it is delayed or it will be a scheduled. A schedule will be June or July. So the mask mandatory policy is gone, but masks are still mandatory in trains and buses. So that's why you still have to wear a mask. But if you're actually heading outside, walking around indoors and outdoors, let me just, except taking trains and buses, you don't need to wear a mask. Or of course you take ferries, then you also need to wear a mask. Just basically, except you're actually going to take public transport, you don't need to wear a mask anymore here in Perth. So sometimes I also don't wear it when I'm outside, but sometimes when it's too crowded, I will still put it on. Alright, still need 7 more minutes, so now it's already 37 minutes for this video, and then the full journey for Mandurah Line is actually 50 something minutes. Hopefully it doesn't go over 1 hour. For the full journey here, then it'll be frustrating. Looks like a train is coming in. I can hear it.
Butler passengers, your next service from platform
1. Or is it just from Butler though? I mean, is it just to Butler? That's towards Butler. Train's coming in. What's the number? 5069. Did I take this train last time? I thought I definitely have took this train last time. I check the number when I get off. Oh, but it's this type of train. Okay, then it's good because I actually can film sitting down. This train runs from Perth to Mandurah, stopping at all stations. Alright, so last time we already did this very similarly. We just entered Willard. Warwick is on the green one. Willard, and this time we need to keep going from Willard, which should be like 20 more minutes to Mandurah from Willard. Because you know, I filmed that one last time. Wanborough to Mandurah, 14 minutes for that one station. Here we go, finally leaving. Next station, Canning Bridge. Alight at Canning Bridge for bus services to Curtin University. Now, just to say, you can probably hear the kids in the background. But in Hong Kong, I have the faith to actually shh at the kids to make them shut up. But here, I don't have the faith. Yeah, so I was just here earlier in the day. I took 9:10 from here to over to Fremantle, but now we take back trains from Fremantle over to Perth and then back here to Canning Bridge, which is way slower. Alight at Canning Bridge for bus services to Curtin University. Next station, Wall Creek. Alright, arrived at Bull Creek on the other side of our terror. So far the highway is pretty smooth outside with not too many jams, but at the front actually before Bull Creek there's actually quite a bit of a jamming there. right, Colburn. Most of the time, people usually, I mean, the train systems, they just call the station Colburn instead of Colburn Central, but the station is called Colburn Central, but. The area around here is kind of called, just called like Colburn, but. Jesus, we still have 6 more stations to go. And we're already 1 hour and 3 minutes now for the video. Owen Grove. Next station, Kwinana.
you'll get revved up, don't you worry. Okay, thank you. See you. Bye.
Quinana. $12.59 for estimate arrival time, which is 23 more minutes. Wow.
Waiting for us. But I remember around the table, all of us together, we've got to be professional.
Rockingham, Warnborough, and Mandurah. Arrived at Rockingham. One time it actually terminates here for one of the days. Trains terminates here, but today it keeps going to Mandurah. warm, bro. Next station, Mandra, where this service terminates. Sorry for not too many talking here, but just enjoy the journey. We still have 9 more minutes for the section. We're arriving at Mandra, where the service terminates. We will get off, and as soon as I get off, I'll end the video. This is way too long, so that's why. almost at Mandra, like around 3 to 4 more minutes then we arrive at Mandra. Has been a very long vlog, very long journey, but hope you guys enjoy this one. I think they really should actually build one extra station between Wombra and Mandra, because this is way too long, way too far away for the section, way too long the section. They should like build one extra station to actually slow it down. Are we at Mandra yet? I'm just worried about this phone is gonna go out of battery. And arrived at Mandra. Let's see which platform we will use. Platform doors open on the right, it is. You might want to drive a little bit faster, mate. This is so slow, what the hell? Anyways, we have arrived at Mandurah. Hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. Thank you so much, Carl Galway, for the request. Remember to like and subscribe. Click the bell so that you can get notifications when I post. Check out the links in the description down below for my other channels and my Instagram. No idea why this is so slow. Alright, Mandurah. And I'll see you guys next time. Click on these videos up top, and peace.